Good morning students. In the previous video we had seen about the fiber alignment and losses. So the next topic we are going to see about the fiber splices. So as I said, a fiber splices is splice is nothing but a permanent joint or a semi-permanent joint. So it is going to be a permanent joint is going to be formed between the two individual optical fibers. It can be done, this joint can be formed in your field or it can be done in the factory. So here where we'll be using these fiber splices is to establish long haul optical fiber links, we'll be using the fiber splices there. So we have two types of splicing. One is fusion splicing, that is nothing but similar to the welding process, and second one is your mechanical splicing. So in your fusion splicing, what we are going to do is we are going to take the two butted or the pre-aligned fiber ends. The fiber ends are going to be taken and these fiber ends are going to be pre-aligned and it is going to be interfaced there. So how we are going to interface is we are going to apply a localized flame to the two fiber ends there. So the localized heating can be done by either a flame or an electric arc. So this flame or electric arc is going to be given at the interface between the two butted pre-aligned fiber ends. So they can soften and fuse together there. That is called fusion splicing. So like how welding of two metals is going to be done, the same way the two fibers are going to be melted by applying a localized heating in the form of a flame or an electric arc, and they soften and fuse together there. Next is mechanical splicing. So mechanical splicing, what we are going to do is this alignment is going to be done by mechanical means. So mechanical means is we are going to use the tubes around the fiber ends. So here in this case we are going to take an optical fiber, that both the fibers are going to be placed inside the tube. So if it is going to be placed inside a capillary tube, we call it as tube splices, or if it is going to be placed in a square end groove, that is V grooves, then in that case we call it as your groove splices. So here prior to splicing, so the splicing operation, both the fibers have to be prepared there. So how we are going to prepare this is like how we are doing a soldering in the case of your and your electronic in your lab. The same way here also what we are going to do is we are going to remove the plastic buffer coating on both the fibers there. Once removing the plastic fiber coating, we are going to cleave the fiber end there. And after cleaving the fiber end with your isopropyl alcohol, we are going to do that. Why we are going to do this plastic buffer coating is going to be removed as well as the fiber end is going to be cleaved is with cleaned with isopropyl alcohol is to get to have a low loss splice there. So the loss should be very minimum there. For that we are doing this preparation there. So here in this case, if I want to form a continuous fiber, the melting of the two fibers can be done to form a continuous fiber there. So the melting can be done by a source of heat. That source of heat can be an electric arc, or it can be a laser, or it can be a gas flame, or a tungsten filament through which the current is going to be passed. So the melting, the heat can be either an electric arc or any one of this parameter there. So here by doing this, we can see that the insertion loss in your splice insertion loss for your multimode fiber is going to be in the range of 0.1 to 0.2 decibels. So your optical fiber in preparation, we are going to see that if it is going to be a curved mandrel, I am going to fold the place that fiber so that they have a smooth and square end surface. So when I want to have a smooth and square end surface, what we are going to do is we are going to do a process called a scribe and break or score and break. Any one name we can call it, because we are going to score the fiber surface under tension. That we are going to pull the fiber surface under tension with a cutting tool there. So the cutting tool can be either a sapphire or it can be diamond or tungsten carbide blade. So here in this case, the surface squaring is going to create failures. Because when the fiber is going to be tensioned, then in that case we can see that a square cable fiber can be produced there. So here if I want to have a straight pull means I can use scribe and break tools are going to be used. So when I use scribe and break tools for straight pull, I can yield a better result there. So when I am going to go for a circumferential scoring, so circumferential scoring is that curvature. In that case, the control method of lightly scoring around the fiber circumference is required. So when a control method is going to be used, we go for circumferential scoring there. So next is the score. Whatever score we are going to prepare, that score should be made smooth and it should be uniform and it should have larger diameter fibers there. So when it is going to have a larger diameter fibers, it can be prepared by a simple straight pull with an end angle less than 1 degree there. So here we are fusion spicing. So as I said, we are going to join the two fibers by the method of heating. So that means that at the fusing point. So that metals are going, the fibers are going to be heated to the fusing point with the sufficient axial pressure that is going to be applied between the two optical fibers. Then in that case, we have to strip the fiber ends and adequately position it, align it so that the good continuity of the transmission medium is going to be achieved at the junction there. So here the fibers are going to be usually positioned and then clamped with the aid of your inspection microscope. Using your microscope, we can position the optical fiber and clamp it, and then we can do the heating process to fuse the two fibers there. So here the flame heating, it can be the flame heating sources can be either your microplasma torches. So if I'm going to use my microplasma torches, the gas what we are going to use is argon and hydrogen gas there. And oxyhydric micro burners means it is going to be oxygen, hydrogen and alcohol vapors I'll be using for micro burners there. So here generally the heat source can be an electric arc. So by using an electric arc, we can control the heat that is going to be used for melting the fibers under the field conditions there. So next is the two fibers will be welded together, and then in that case the rounding of the fibers, here in this case the two fibers will be welded together by the arc fusion process there. So when it's going to go follow the arc fusion process, the fiber ends are going to be rounded off. So when it is going to be rounded off, it is going to have a low energy discharge is going to occur. And when a low energy discharge is going to occur, then in that case, before the pressing the fibers together and then fusing it with a stronger arc. So when I'm going to bring the fibers, during the melting stage, we are going to give a low energy discharge there. One, then by giving a low energy discharge, we are going to press both the fibers, and once we pressed it is melt, starts to melt, we are going to give a higher, stronger arc so that it will fuse together there. So this technique is going to be called as your prefusion, where it is going to remove the requirement of your fiber end preparation there. And this is going to be advantageous in your field environment. So it can be used with multimode fibers, where the average splice loss is going to be 0.09 decibels. So here we can see the diagram there. We are going to use a micro positioner. So with the help of this micro positioner, we can align the fiber there. Your fiber alignment can be done. So here this is your push lever, where the fiber can be adjusted, the alignment of the fiber can be adjusted, and we are going to have a stop lever there. So stop lever, it will stop at the particular point till this alignment is going to be proper there. So we are going to have two blocks, one is your fixed block and the other one is going to be a movable block. In this fixed block, we are going to have a groove over which we are going to place the one optical fiber there. And next is, you are going to have a movable block. In the movable block, we are going to have another fiber, and this fiber is going to be moved and adjusted in such a way that the axis of the fiber coincides there. So now we are going to place an electrode there. This electrodes will give a slower electric discharge is going to take place. When slower electric discharge is going to take place, the melting operation is going to take place. That means your energy is going to be developed. So here in this case, once the melting starts, then what we are going to do is we are going to press these two fibers. When the fibers are going to be pressed together, a strong arc is going to be passed so that the fusion can take place at the exact alignment there. So then we can see that the fibers are going to be joined. So these are the four processes there. One is the initial setting. Initial setting is, this is one fiber, this is another fiber, these are the electrodes which is going to send the electric discharge, the electric discharge arc there. Next is, at the initial stage, once it is aligned, we are going to give the smooth surface by prefusion method. Prefusion method is nothing but a low electric discharge is going to be given. So when it is going to be given, you are going to start the melting of the fibers is going to take place. Once the melting starts, we are going to apply pressure on both the ends of the fiber. So when it is going to be pressed, the two fibers will join together by giving a strong electric arc here. So when the strong electric arc is going to be given and the pressure is going to be given on both the ends, these two fibers will fuse together and see that the fibers are going to be joined. So we can have the fibers to be joined with a proper alignment of the core axis there. So here fusion splice principles. So here in this case, this is going to have a V groove there. So V groove is here, we are going to have a V groove. In this, we are going to have the fiber to be placed, and this is a movable. Again, we have a V groove where the fiber is going to be placed, and these are nothing but the V grooves which are going to be used for the fiber alignment there. So here cleaved fiber ends are going to be fused permanently. This cleaved fiber ends are going to be fused permanently using an electric arc. So during the splicing fibers, fiber areas are going to be held in the V grooves for alignment. So here in this fiber alignments, fibers are going to be held in the V grooves for the alignment purpose there. So a variety of splices can be developed to be used in your multi-mode and single mode fiber there. So the cleaving step is, one is nick. So this is going to be a fiber, this is your fiber. We are going to apply a nick there. So nick is nothing but polishing the fiber there. Next is apply the force. So apply the force to the fiber. Then after that we are going to cleave it. So when I'm going to cleave it, this fiber is going to be divided into two halves with a small air gap that is going to be present. So here your fiber and this is your curved form. We are going to have a fiber to be present. When I want to bend the fiber, I'm going to do first the cleaving of the fiber is going to be done. Then I'm going to apply the tension to the two ends of the fiber and pull the fiber. So when I'm going to pull the fiber should be aligned to the position there. For that I'll be using a scoring blade to align the fiber, and with the help of the tension at the two ends, the fibers will be extended. So here in this case, for the smooth face end, I'm going to have a small loop, and for a smooth surface, I can have a hackled surface there. So the steps is the same thing what we have said. We have your initial setting, your profusion, your fusion process, and your pull test process. By doing the pull test process, we can see the strength of the fiber joints there. So next is the fusion splicing of the single mode fibers. So the single mode fibers, if I am going to take, the typical core diameter is going to be from 5 micrometers to 10 micrometers there. So here when I am going to use a very low core diameter, in that case the fiber alignment is going to be critical. So when it is going to be critical, there is going to be the lateral offset should be less than 1 micrometer there. So for the low loss joints, the lateral offset should be less than 1 micrometer. So here for the splice insertion loss, which is going to be below 0.3 decibels, it can be achieved by the self-alignment phenomenon there. So here in this case, when I'm going to go for self-alignment phenomenon, we can compensate for any lateral offset there. So the drawback of this self-alignment phenomenon is the heat is necessary to fuse the fibers. So when I'm going to use the heat to fuse the fibers, it may weaken the fiber there. So here when I'm going to the fiber is going to be weakened in the vicinity of the splice there. So as a result, the tensile strength of the fused fiber will be very low, as much as 30% of the uncoated fiber before the fusion. Next is mechanical splicing. So mechanical splicing is the fibers are going to be held in alignment by some mechanical means. So here in this case, by some mechanical means, we have fibers, both the fibers, we are going to keep it in some alignment there. So here we have two types of splices. One is your tube splice, the other one is your groove splice. Tube splice is nothing but the tube splices are going to be used around the fiber ends, that is glass or ceramic capillary. V grooves are going to be used into which the butted fibers are going to be placed, that is groove splices. So single tube or snug tie or tube splice is nothing but the glass or the ceramic capillary is going to be taken with an inner diameter is going to be large enough so that this optical fiber can be inserted into the glass or ceramic capillary there. So then before that we are going to inject a transparent adhesive, that is nothing but epoxy resin is going to be injected through a traverse bore, that is through the gap in the capillary, so that it can give a mechanical sealing and the index matching can be done for the splice there. So first is, before inserting the optical fiber, we are going to see that a transparent adhesive is going to be injected into the fiber there. So through a transverse bore or in the capillary, so that it can do the mechanical sealing of the both the fibers, and the index matching can also be done. So in this case, the average insertion loss is going to be as low as 0.1 decibels, and it can be used in your multimode graded index and single mode fibers using ceramic capillaries there. Next is your loose tube splice utilizing square cross section capillary. So square cross section capillaries, the capillary what we are going to use is going to be a square shape. So in this square shape, it is going to avoid the critical tolerance requirement of the snug tube. In the snug tube, we should see that the diameter should be designed in such a way that the core, the fiber should be able to enter into the core, into the capillary there. But in this case, that critical tolerance requirement is going to be avoided in the case of square cross section capillary there. So we are going to use a loose tube splice there, where it is going to be an oversized square section there. So where in this oversized square section, we are going to insert a metal tube. So where it is going to be easily accepted, which is going to accept this fiber ends there. So here first the transparent adhesive is going to be, that epoxy resin is going to be first inserted into the tube, followed by the fibers. So here in this case, the splice is going to be self-aligned. So the splice will be self-aligned when the fibers are curved in the same plane. So here in this case, forcing the fiber ends to simultaneously into the same corner of the tube. So when I'm going to do, the insertion loss is going to be around 0.073 decibels can be achieved. So next is V-groove splice. V-groove splices, we are going to use grooves. Grooves is this V-shape here. These grooves are going to be used to secure the fibers in place. So by placing the fibers, we can join the two fibers there. So for that, we are going to use an epoxy resin there. So the V-groove splice is going to give the alignment for the prepared fiber ends through the insertion in the groove there. So here the splice is going to be made permanent by securing the fibers in the V groove with epoxy resin is going to be inserted between the two fiber ends there. So here in this case, the insertion loss is going to be around 0.1 decibels. Next is spring groove splice. Spring groove splice is nothing but a bracket which is going to contain two cylindrical pins there. So here this is nothing but, this round is nothing but the cylindrical pin. The cylindrical pin is going to serve as an alignment for this fiber here. So where the fiber is going to be placed between these two cylindrical pins. And here in this case, the cylindrical pin diameter is going to be chosen so that the fibers are be able to protrude outside the cylindrical pins there. So then an elastic element. So elastic element is nothing but the spring is going to be used to press the fibers into the groove there and maintain the fiber end alignment. The spring will be pressed onto this fiber end so that these fibers will be joined and maintain the fiber end alignment there. So the complete assembly is going to be secured using a drop of epoxy resin there. So in this case, the insertion loss is going to be 0.05 decibels, which is going to be obtained in the case of multimode graded index fibers using the spring groove splice.